Hey guys, welcome back to the Node video tutorial. So till now we have learned how to create a get API and how to create a post API, and from the get API how to get the queries from the front end, whatever queries sending by the client, how to get that using the request.query. Similarly, whenever post API is being called, how to, whenever front end is sending data inside the body, how to get that data using request.body we can get. Till now these things. Okay, so what we have to do, once we will get the data from the front end or from the client, we have to store it somewhere. That is nothing but we have to store it in the database. Okay, so how to store all those data in the database, we will see. Okay, we will see now in this tutorial. Okay, so let's see how to store it in the database. Okay, so for that you can see here, this is nothing but my previous code. I'll just remove the commenting part. Already I have shown how it is working, so I'll just remove the commenting parts so that it will be looks good now. Okay, now let's stop the server and close it. Okay, see, you can see now I have installed, I have required express, I have required body parser to read the body which is coming from the post method body part, and we are using this body parser. Then we have created one API that is nothing but our get API. Here I have created another API that is nothing but our post API. Okay, so till now we have just consoling whatever is coming from the front end. Okay, we are not doing anything with that data, we are just printing and leaving that, but I need to save it somewhere. So how to do that, let's check. Okay, so for that we have to use one database called MongoDB. Okay, so MongoDB, for MongoDB I have already told how to install MongoDB. If you have not installed MongoDB, then you can go here, you can go here and you can type install MongoDB. Okay, if you have Ubuntu you can use Ubuntu, if you have Windows machine you can use Windows machine, anything fine. Okay, so you can go to the document part of this MongoDB, the official website of the MongoDB, and you can install MongoDB for Windows. If you have not installed, if you have installed, that's fine, perfectly fine. Then to visualize the data, whatever we have inserted the database, to visualize the data we have to install one more thing, that is called NoSQL booster. This is nothing but the UI of the MongoDB database. Okay, this is nothing but, you can see the smartest GUI admin tool for MongoDB. Okay, we can install that also. I have already told the prerequisites video that how to install all those things. You have to install all those things to visualize the data. Okay, so in my system I have already installed MongoDB, so I just need to connect this to the MongoDB and we have to work on that only. But if you have not installed, please install, then only it will work. Okay, so now to set the data or to play with the database, we have to use another predefined module called Mongoose. In future many persons are using one module called MongoDB, is also a module. If you can check here, npm mongoose. Okay, you can see there is a predefined module is called Mongoose. Similarly, so you can say Mongoose is a MongoDB object modeling tool designed to work in a asynchronous environment. Mongoose support both promises and callbacks. That is nothing but our callback. I have make you understand already what is callback. Promises is nothing but, you need to understand right now. So this is nothing but the to handle with the, to communicate with the MongoDB. Okay, so we can use the Mongoose npm. Similarly, one more famous npm is exist, or many persons, many engineers are using that is nothing but MongoDB. MongoDB npm, that npm name is itself is a MongoDB. Okay, so anything can find MongoDB and Mongoose. Only the difference is there, you need not to create schema in the MongoDB. If you are using MongoDB npm, you need not to create the schema in your application level. Altogether, MongoDB no required of MongoDB to create the schema in the database level. Okay, but in the whenever you will use the Mongoose, you need to create the schema in your application level. That means whenever you are creating the Node.js, in the Node.js you have to create schema if you are using Mongoose npm. If you are not using MongoDB npm, you need not to even create the schema in your Mongo, in your Node.js application also. But I am preferring you should first go and test with Mongoose npm, so that you can able to understand how whole database actually working, how schema is creating in the application level instead of database level. Database level means you have to go to the database and you have to create the schema. Rather than creating schema in the database level, we are creating the schema in the application level. That is nothing but our Node.js application. In the our Node.js application, we are creating the schema. Let's use Mongoose so that you can able to understand everything correctly. Later on, whenever you will be more experienced, so you can use your MongoDB also. There is nothing but much different to use this Mongoose. There is all together documents is clearly given, the documents. Even you can get any other resource also. Many resources are used MongoDB npm, so you can use that also. But we are using Mongoose, so we will use Mongoose. Okay, so for that we have to install Mongoose and we have to require that. Okay, let's install Mongoose and start our work. Okay, so npm install --, save Mongoose. Okay, let me install. So this is the Mongoose npm. Okay, but for that also we have Mongoose official website. Okay, official site, you can see here, to get the functions. Okay, how to save data, how to read data. For that, all those things, we have Mongoose official website here. Okay, so here I can go read the docs. Okay, here Mongoose all these required documentation are there. So you can see we have to require Mongoose, then we have to create the schema. How to create the schema, all those things are there documented. All whole full documentation are there, which you can refer this documentation. But before referring their documentation, I must recommend you first create basic Mongoose, first use basic of this Mongoose, so that you can, whenever you will go to the documentation, you can understand the documentation. But if you will not, if you will just directly start from this documentation, you may feel little difficulties to understand this documentation. So that's why I am creating this video, so that you can understand first little bit basics, how to use this, how we can use Mongoose. Then only you can refer this documentation and you can use that Mongoose more often whenever more complex logics will come. Okay, so I have already installed that, let's use that. Okay, so what I will do, I will create Mongoose here. I will just use Mongoose is equal to require. I am just requiring, since I have already installed, I will just requiring Mongoose. Okay, so Mongoose is now installed or installed and required. Okay, so what I have to do, this is my APIs, right? So before my APIs, I have to create, just after this I have to create, this is a rule you have to follow. Okay, you can create also after this also, not problem, but it's better to create here. But in future we will make it in a separate folder structure. Whenever folder structure will come, we'll see that. But right now let's create here. we have to connect to the MongoDB. Right now, using Mongoose, we have to connect to the MongoDB. How to connect? Mongoose.connect function is there. You can see all those functions exist in this documentation also, but I am not going through this documentation right now. Whatever I am doing, just follow all those things. You can able to understand all these things. Okay, so this function taking three parameters, maximum two, three parameters it is taking. One is URL. Okay, URL can be in a string. Okay, that is nothing but URL. Okay, so let me give the syntax here. Syntax to connect to MongoDB using Mongoose. Okay, so here how to do Mongoose dot connect three parameter. One is URL, second one is option. We may give, we may not give. Then third one is callback function. Okay, sorry, this is the syntax. Okay, so what is the first URL? How URL can be given? URL can be given like this. URL can be given like this. Protocol. Then your MongoDB. Then your IP address. Okay, then port number, by default it is running. Okay, by default MongoDB is running in which port, we have to see. Okay, MongoDB port number, you can see MongoDB port number by default 27017. Okay, so we have to give this 27017. Okay, then we have to give the database name. Okay, database name. Okay, this much things we have to give. So how to give this? Protocol name is nothing but MongoDB. Okay, so then IP is nothing but our local host. Okay, then we have to give the database, sorry, port number 27017. So generally MongoDB by default run in the port number 27017. Okay, so we have to give that. Then we have to give database name. For example, my node tutorial. Okay, this is nothing but my database name. Okay, then see, is telling that, taking that second parameter would be option. That means it may be there, it may not be there. Okay, so I will just, this option can be only a object. Okay, so I will just create the blank object and leave it. Okay, then callback function. What will come in the that object, I will see later. Okay, callback function will take two parameters. One is error, one is success. So while connecting to the database, error may occur, error may happen. If error will occur, what I have to do? If success will occur, what I have to do? Okay, so if error will occur, what will I have to do? Throw this error. Okay, if error will not occur, obviously it will success. So I will just console.log, I will just print MongoDB connected successfully. Okay, this is nothing but our connection path. Okay, let's see whenever we will run. Okay, let's see whenever I will run, I must see this message. If this message I am not seeing, then there must be some problem to connect into the MongoDB. We just installed and require here, we are now connecting. Okay, let's see whether connection is happening or not. Until we have not connected to the MongoDB, we cannot store or we cannot communicate with the MongoDB. So that connection part is important. Let's see how to connect this MongoDB. Okay, this is the method, this is the way we can connect. Okay, let's see node-server.js. See, right now it is showing MongoDB connected successfully, but it is showing some, you can see it is showing some warning. That warning is absolutely fine, no need to worry about that. If warning is coming, see, you can see current URL string parser is deprecated. Okay, this deprecation warning is coming and will be removed in the future version. Whenever future version will come, this can be removed. So he is telling that pass this option, I have to kept here blank. Okay, she is telling that pass this option in this option. Okay, if you will pass, this warning will be remove. If you will not pass, that's okay, that's fine, we need not to worry about that. But still, to remove that warning, our MongoDB is already connected. Even if you will not give that, this, that's fine, it will work perfectly fine. But just to remove that warning, I am giving this true. Okay, then I will again restart. You can see one warning gone, second warning is telling that again we have to give you use unified topology at true. Okay, again this is another object, but we have to give only one object, we have to give. Then what I can do, I can comma, I can give like this. Okay, this is nothing but our second parameter, which is nothing but our object. So third parameter will be our callback function, first parameter our URL. Okay, you can see here like this, mongoose.connect, first parameter our URL, second parameter our option, third parameter, if we will not give this option, it will show some warning message, which is absolutely fine. Okay, to remove, to avoid that warning message, you have to give this much. Okay, then third parameter is nothing but our callback function. Inside the callback function, if error will occur, then we are throwing that error. If error will not occur, we are just showing the MongoDB connected successfully. Okay, let's see. See, you can see it's still current server discover, it's still showing as true. Okay, that's fine. Let it be there. Why it is coming, let's not worry about that, it is there. So right now MongoDB is connected successfully. That means our MongoDB is connected successfully. We can communicate with MongoDB right now through this API. Okay, through, whenever we will get the data, we have to store data in the database, we have to get data from the database through API. Okay, so our MongoDB is connected successfully, we can store data in the database, we can get the data from the database. Okay, for that, to storing data or getting data, we have to create this schema. As I told already, Mongo's need application level of creating this schema. We will see in the next video how to create this schema. Then we will see how to save data in the database. Okay, so this is nothing but the introduction to how to to the MongoDB and how to connect to the MongoDB using Node.js, using Mongo's npm in Node.js. Okay, so in coming video we will see how to create a schema, then we will see how to push or how to save data in the database. Okay, so keep watching, keep practicing.